Lyft is experimenting with a new pay structure, and they're bringing it to 6 markets starting next week, in which the drivers will get paid from the moment you hit accept, you go and pick up your passenger, you take your passenger and you drop them off, and then it ends. So in this video, I'm going to share with you the details that we know as of right now. And stick around, because at the end of the video, I'm going to share with you whether I think this is a good thing or a bad thing for drivers. Hey everybody, this is Jay Crater with The Rideshare Guy. And earlier this week, I was invited to attend a meeting to hear about this new kind of radical pay structure change that Lyft is experimenting with in 6 markets starting next week. It's currently in Seattle and it's going to go into 5 other markets next week. So the idea is that instead of getting paid when you pick up a passenger, you're gonna get paid from the moment you hit the ping. So all that time that you go to drive towards the passenger, you're gonna get paid for that, as well as from when you pick up the passenger to when you drop them off. Now, Lyft started off by sharing with me some statistics. So let's take a look at those first. The first thing we're looking at here is that Lyft says that 91% of all drivers drive less than 20 hours per week, and 76%, or 3 out of 4, drive less than 10 hours per week. So what they're saying there is that most drivers are part-timers. Drivers like me that drive more than 20 hours, there's only 10% of us, 10% of us that are actually doing that much driving. It's an interesting statistic. So it was a change in philosophy. So it used to be you wanted to reduce your wait time. You wanted to reduce the amount of time you would have to go pick up your passengers to as little as possible because you weren't getting paid for that. So like in San Francisco, if I have a pickup and it's 11 minutes or more away, I don't go. I cancel because that's too long, because I know if I wait another minute or two, I'll probably get one that's like 5 minutes away. But in other markets, it's common that you might have to wait 20 minutes. You might drive 20 minutes or 30 minutes to go pick up a passenger because the demand isn't so high. So with this new program, you'll get paid for that. Let's say it's a 30 minute ride to get to pick up a passenger. That whole 30 minutes, you're gonna get paid. And then once you pick up the passenger, you're gonna get paid the same rate taking them to their destination. So that's the concept, that's the new philosophy, and they're testing this in 6 markets. So let me show you what those 6 markets are. As you see in this graphic, the markets are Seattle, Honolulu, Lihu, which is in Hawaii, Boise, Roswell, and Lake Havasu City in California. Of course, the big question is, well, what are the rates? And we have very limited information when it comes to the rates. We get the sense that Lyft is fine-tuning the rates so that it works for Lyft and isn't too much of a pay cut for the drivers. So let's look at this graphic, which is what was going out to our drivers in the Seattle market. And as you can see, it explains start earning as soon as you tap accept. So you get, there's a few other things that they're doing as well. You're gonna get paid for every shared pickup, and you're gonna get paid for pickup time and distance. And it says they're valuing your time and there are the rates, okay? So number 4 is really important, like how does this compare to the old rates? So we do have this information in Honolulu. So what you're seeing right now is a graphic that compares the Honolulu rates current, which I'm calling before, and then after, and then you can see the net change. So what you're seeing here is that the base rate is going down by 70%, the per minute is going up by 55%, the per mile is going down 49%, and the minimum rate is going down by 25%. So here again, what we're gonna have to analyze is, well, how is this really going to affect you as a driver? And every driver drives a little bit differently depending on the market that you're in. If you're in a market where you have long pickups, this might work out for you. But if you're in a market like where I am, where the pickups are short and the rates are getting cut this much, this could be devastating. But let's do a few analysis here. So number 5, is this good or bad? So let's just take a look at numbers that I put together, and I made up some scenarios. So what you see in the first scenario is what I would call a typical airport run. And these are using the Hawaii rates. But in this example, it's 10 minutes and 2 miles to make the pickup. And then the airport run is 30 minutes and 20 miles. So in total, when you add those both up, it's 40 minutes and 22 miles. Now, calculating with the old earnings versus the new earnings, you can see I would earn less, 20% less. Okay. Now, if you look at example number two, which is a lot of traffic, I created a scenario where the driving time is longer for the same amount of miles. You can see the rate goes up by, I earn 24% more. And then in the third example, what I call across town, where I've got a pickup of 5 minutes, the drive is 20 minutes and 10 miles, so I'm averaging 30 miles per hour. In that case, it's a decrease of 18%. So what are the key takeaways here? Well, it's really too soon to tell. Once we get the rates for more markets, then we can look at in a week's worth of driving, let's say in 100 trips in a week, what does this average out to? Well, my gut feeling is that if you're in a market where you have the longer wait times, the longer pickups to go get your passengers, this might actually increase your rates a little bit. But if you're in a market like where I am in San Francisco, where the pickup times are pretty short, this could be devastating because the per mileage rate is getting cut so dramatically. This is similar to what we saw last year, where the per minute went up, the per mile went way down, and the net in San Francisco, we took a full week, was a 4% decrease. So I expect this is going to have the same impact, but we really won't know until we get the numbers, if this expands beyond the six markets that they're in right now. But if Lyft finds a way to lower the amount that they're paying drivers, you can sure bet they're going to do it, and they are going to expand it out to the rest of the country because this will affect their bottom line. And now that they're a public company, this is very important. Thanks for watching. If you have not subscribed yet to this YouTube channel, by all means, please do. We'd love to have you as part of the team. This is Jay Crater with The Rideshare Guy. Y'all go out and have a great day. Be safe out there.